now that I cut the card, let me show you what I did. So the card came out like that, but since her colors are like a aqua robin egg, I went ahead and cut a shiny one. I'm sorry about the reflection. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put a lot of adhesive into this one so I can glue it in here. And I'm going to try to use the tumble for this one. Go ahead and put that here on the side. I think I'm gonna put like a, but I know I'm gonna put, my scotch tape to kind of adhere it there. All right, and then meanwhile I cut a 2 3/8 circle, and I use also my maker to cut the number 16 so I can put it in here. And for this I'm gonna use my tweezers here, and again I'm gonna use tumble on this one. I need a strong adhesive. Let's see. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and put that in there. And then I'm gonna do the number one. Okay. Let's see. Try to align it here. Okay, so I got that. I'm going to use a paperweight to hold it. Let's see. I'm going to let it dry for 1 second here. And I want to make sure that my card here is dry. And I'm gonna get some dimensionals so I can glue the 16 in there. And the tumble dries pretty fast, so I got a little bit of glue here. That's the only thing I don't like about the tumble. It kind of mats. Kind of makes the paper not matte about. think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put some bling in here on the little shell in here. So let me get overdo it, but it's already blinged out, so let me back out so you can see it. Let's see. All right, so that's my first project with my Cricut maker, and I am extremely happy on how it cuts the paper, the 105-pound paper, and then it also cuts the glitter paper like butter. Really recommend it, and until next time, thanks for stopping by, and happy crafting.